Do you think? That.
Yeah, I did. Of course you did. I kind of came to a connection when you were talking, and I kind of want to know what you think about it. You said something along the lines of, it's not necessarily an opiate crisis. Do you think that at the root of the opiate crisis could be a culture crisis? People not knowing themselves or not knowing their family or not knowing where they came from or their roots?
Like no identity. No.
Yeah, I think, you know, not too long ago, my grandson was in jail, right? So I went to court, and the first 6-8 guys that came out in that courtroom were young Native guys, and it broke my heart. It angered me, and they're all walking out like they're all tough and badass and cool, and I wanted to get up there and smack every one of them, you know? And then I got to thinking, they're lost. They're really lost, you know? It's like, I see this a lot, you know, these young Indian kids walk around all Indian and proud and stuff, but they don't know what that means, you know? The only way they can identify is living on a res and being brown, you know? Being poor, you know, all the jokes that go with being Native, you know, Kamad jokes, whatever, but, I think it's an identity thing, you know, because if I think about these young kids that are going through the lodge, the Made Lodge, you know, they're getting their teachings, they're 8 years old, 10 years old, 12 years old, you know, and the parents that are seeing to it that they get to those ceremonies, you know, are healthy. You know, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually, and the kids are gonna, you know, they're hopefully teaching their kids and going through the ceremonies and stuff. Those kids are gonna know this is not the way of the Anishinaabe people. You know, it's killing our people. It's killing our young people. You know, it happens at least once a week. They just buried a young man last week, you know, and it's happening once a week on all the reservations, and that's really sad. It really, really is. You know, who knows what that person that died of a drug overdose could have done for our people, you know? It's really sad, you know? And then I think about once they are addicted, you know, it is so hard to stop. So hard to stop. I mean, I deal with my own addictions every day. I smoke cigarettes. It's hard to stop. I know that. You know? I'm a recovering alcoholic. It was hard to stop. I saw my son come out of prison. He had no coping skills. And, you know, somebody needs to be there for those people. And just to learn basic life stuff, and nobody's there. You know, the mothers of our young people today, they're in their 40s and in their 50s, and their mothers are people my age, and I think about that, and it's like, where did we go wrong, my generation, you know? Where did we mess up? Why those mothers are like that, even my own daughter, you know? But, you know, like I said, my kids have had teachings. They know. Maybe I wasn't there when I should have been, I don't know. That would have changed anything. You know, there's just so much out there for kids, you know, and young people, and everybody wants to be cool, you know, and I hate it when they call each other. You see these young girls on social media all the time calling each other niggas and bitches. And it's like, we're not that, you know? We're Anishinaabe women. We're beautiful Anishinaabe women. we're not niggas and we're not bitches. It's like, stop that. So. Can I answer your question?
Is culture the answer?
Oh, yeah. Yes, I believe culture is the answer. And identity, just, you know, if you really walk proud as an Indian man, an Indian woman, it's something that you feel inside of you. It really is, you know. I can't explain it beyond that, but it comes from the heart, you know. And I heard this man one time talk about the Ojibwe language, and the way he said the word heart was so beautiful. The interpretation in Ojibwe was so beautiful in comparison to just the word heart. You know, when we hear heart, we see our blood pumping in. But to the Ojibwe people and in the Ojibwe language, it was just beautiful. I wish I could remember it all, you know. But it had to do with...
Do you remember any of it?
Some of it had to do with, you know, our heart is, you know, right here, you know, for the women, it's right on our breast because we give life, we nurture that infant, and it had to do with the sound of the drum, you know, the way our heart beats, and that infant hears that all the time, and it's like, you know, they're just automatically drawn to that drum, you know. So, and I heard this joke not too long ago about, mothers not nursing anymore, and they didn't know why their kids were all running around out there. And this old man said, they're out there looking for their mother, the cow, you know, because we all drink cow's milk today, you know, instead of being nursed the way it was intended to be. But I believe that, you know, we really need to go back to those ways. And I hate saying going back because, you know, with all the other movements I was talking about, there is a cultural movement happening. And there are younger people seeking. You know, the seventh generation people are seeking. But not all of them have found us yet. But I believe, I have hope. You know, I have hope they will. They'll get there. Like I said, we've all been sleeping for a long time. And our people are waking up now.
Is culture the answer?
Culture, yes, I believe culture will give our young people a sense of what it is, what true pride in their culture is, because our young people see a different culture on a screen or hear through music, and so they try to emulate what they see and what they hear, and I personally, from my own experience, went that way as well, because I didn't have culture, and my mom did the best she could, you know, with what she had and what she learned, and I'm grateful for that, you know. But the influences of society and music and the gangster life, you know, going, it's like that culture is not who we are, you know. When we get our culture back, you know, we help our family, our elders, we teach our little ones, you know, just give without even thinking, you know, and that's been a part of my journey, you know, because I've gained my culture back, you know, and my sense of who I am, you know, what blood I have in my veins, you know, makes me proud, you know. for that, you know. And you know, we have all these other cultures, you know, around this world, you know. And it's that gangster life, that dog life, that's spread, you know. And it's went across seas, and it's out there in the east, and you know, it's coming back, you know, it's coming back this way, and it's